decide to do a karate competition, what are you trying to, what's your point? What are you trying to accomplish? Huh?
I can't hear you.
Win. How do you, well, how do you go about winning? Huh? All right, we have to get a font, right? And that's really important. What do you score in baseball? You score points in baseball? Speak loud.
Runs.
Football is what?
Touchdowns.
And extra points. Not points, but extra points. Basketball is what?
Baskets.
Goals. Right? Baskets, whatever it is. And then you total all the points with the number of baskets. Okay, that's one way of looking at it. What do you score in golf? Strokes. They count strokes. All right? So a lot of sports don't have points, do they? What do you score in tennis? What's going on with that? Nobody's been able to figure that one out yet. You score something in tennis and you win. Nobody's been able to quite figure that. But you understand. So the first thing we have to have in our heads, which is karate, is that we don't score points. Now, if you want to score points, don't join the USATF. Go to the open competition and score points. You can go win medals and trophies and things in open competition because they score points. We don't score points. We score a pot and we score Rosario. And that means something different. You don't get to get your punch down. That's why we have all the technical stuff, because the technique has to be there. If you don't have the technique behind it, it's not going to score. And rightly so. Because the rules are designed to score karate technique, not just score whatever it is you think you want to be a karate technique. Okay? So, what's in the pond?
Superior technique.
If you took a karate course, you wouldn't even get in the door for that answer. That's okay, I'm glad you mentioned it that way. You get some thinking more. Alright, what's in the pond?
Six of the requirements.
Just six of the requirements, maybe?
Seven.
There are seven.
Eight.
Right, six criteria for a pond. You have to have all six. You answered the question implying that there were probably more than six. You said six out of some number. So I want to know what the number was I could choose from. All six criteria must be. All right. Now you guys know this really well, and I know you're going to keep quiet. What are the six criteria? Now, how many here competed internationally? Raise your hand. Good. You guys know what the six criteria are, don't you? What are those? The first one. Have you ever won a medal internationally?
Yes.
And you don't know what you're doing?
I'm scoring the pond.
Well, you know that you're doing it, but you don't know what it is, do you? You can't tell me what the quantums are. You just might be able to show me. See, and I want you guys not just to be able to do it, but I want you to have some understanding of what you're trying to do. So I don't mean to cut you up that way. I'm just trying to make a point here. You can cry. I think you know these since you've been here before. Peter, what? That's one criteria. How do you spell it? I don't know if I spelled it right or wrong either.
Okay.
Hime? It's not one of the six criteria listed in the book of the world. But we're going to come back to Hime. What?
Sanjin.
All right. What else? Not in the rules. It's not a requirement for the pond. You mean I have to remember these stuff?
Honey.
Not nothing to do with it. Demi has nothing to do with it. What do you have to have? Good form! Vigorous attitude! What else? So, put it for him. Where's his application? My, correct that presumption. What's the last one?
Just because you
you go up and you just punch, and figure something out of land, and the other guy can't do anything anyway. And sometimes in the weak divisions, we score those because there's nothing else to score. You see, sometimes you guys get score points because Nash is so slow that we don't score something, we'll be there all day. Referees think that way. Now, hopefully for this advanced group period, we don't have that problem. But we do have that problem later on. So, the attitude, technique, and vigor. And now, correct attitude. Well, what does correct attitude mean? Here, now, this is the trap that you were on. What's correct attitude? I wanted to say that you could take a score. This is your intent. This is where the intent comes in. In other words, not positive. I know what you're saying. That's a good word, but the thing is that I mean for this one to be a score, referee. I set him up here. I break the front. He can drop his guard. My punch is there. Blow. I key out. And I draw the referee's attention to that. That's what I want it to be. Okay? This is the attitude. This is the killing blow. This is the technique I want you to see. I want you to recognize that. I want you to award that to me. That's what you're doing. So accidental hits don't score. How many times you hit somebody and the referee doesn't give it to you? Sometimes you guys come in with worried techniques and they go, that's going to get worse, it's not going to get better. Because you guys are getting in a higher level competition. And a higher level competition is going to require a higher standard. Not a lot of change in what you do. Some of you may not even have to change anything. You might be pretty rigorous out of it. You might have a good attitude. But you have tactics, you have strategy, you have techniques. Okay? The strategy is how you're going to do the match, the tactics are what you're going to do in the match, and the techniques are what you do the tactics with. That's simple. So you just don't walk out there and fight anymore. Okay, that's some idea of what you're going to do. Alright, now, the next two, distance sanction. And time. Really, hand in hand. Okay? And it's awful hard to discuss one without discussing the other. Alright, so what is distance mean? This is where it gets tough, yes. Andrew. Okay. That is a good start. I wouldn't say that's 100% though. Yes. Yeah, it has to be where it's supposed to be in order to score, right? Okay. Acceptable. Now the referees don't know this. What do they do? Now, we're like this. And we'll try to, you're going to pay a little bit, but let me teach you how to teach. Okay, so he backs up. 7 point. Somebody wanted to say yes. Who wanted to say yes? You want to say yes. You want to say yes. Who wants to say no? Okay, we'll let the yeses answer first. Why is that a point? Thank you. starts his punch, and I get him while he's moving into my punch, bingo, right? That's good timing. You know, Mr. Andrew, the one time we had a Beckel, and we were senior USA team in 84, so our junior fight their juniors, and Mr. Anderson that we lose every match, 2-1-1. Okay. And what happened was, our guys landed this really strong on a new hard, and drove him to reverse punch. And the guy just nailed him with the front hand. The Japanese just did this, boom. And they caught our guy turning, and every single punch, the guy turned forward, their punch was there, and they literally turned and nailed their body on a Japanese contestant's fist. You see that? Beautiful timing, wasn't it? Huh? Well, let me ask you this. If he's fast, if he's really fast, right? Okay, I want you to go fast when you start. No, you just have to start poking. Who hit who first?
She was at the same time.
Got there at the same time. Didn't we? Hmm? Unfortunately, it was his fist on my body instead of my back is his nose. But we got there at the same time. And that's important, because what you have to understand is that when you're fighting, and you hit, and you're both there at the same time. Timing will win. Whoever has the timing. He can be faster, and he can get there first. But if I'm over here, I've got it. So timing skills are another matter. But that's what we're talking about. So you have an understanding of distance, and you have an understanding of timing. All right? Okay. So the last one is Dan-shin. What's Dan-shin? Great. What's the remaining mind? I'm tired of hearing it. I want somebody to come with me.
Focus after technique is poor.
When you get the shot, you can be able to recover by taking the second shot from here.
That's what I'm saying. What's that got to do with the main mind?
Keeping your mind open for an advance or
not. Why would you
be keeping your mind open?
Well, you got to get to someone. Yes. What? Do you have pardon? Well, I'm going to put it to you a little differently. Okay, there's lots of different explanations of what Dan-shin is. All right, but what I'm going to tell you is this, is that you don't lose concept in your head of what you're doing. If you're fighting, you're fighting. And you don't turn your mind away from that fight for an instant. All right? You don't lose control of what you're doing. Now, that is what we're talking about here. And that's what you demonstrate. When you score that point, referee, and come back and you take a good, strong posture, which is what? The posture counts on shin. Okay? Well, no, you're not wrong. You're not wrong. The posture counts on shin, but the posture is an expression of your attitude. That's what we're saying. And you come back with a real strong attitude, and your mind stays blocked. If you have a second punch, you're ready to block it. And you're ready to go because you don't know if that referee's going to give you praise for your technique. What can you be praise for you by giving you a point, right? Right? No, he praise you by giving you a pawn. He doesn't give you a point. Don't let me trick you on that, okay? Right? So, what I'm trying to say here is that you're in a circumstance, and your mind stays in that circumstance until it's over. And it stays there until the referee goes, man! And still, a few seconds later, the referee still doesn't hit you after the ombud, right? And then you go back. Then your mind can break. So you want to demonstrate to me that your technique was meant to score, and then afterwards you're ready to kill him, do it again, or whatever. Your mind's right on top of him, and it's a stronger mind than he is. His. Okay? So if you can break somebody's Dan-shin, then you can score in a pawn. Right? Because you break his concentration, you create a weakness.